she whispers, pistol clattering away. She's lost her grip in the shock. It's already too late to hide anything else. Another step closer and the overhead light illuminates the full horror of his stricken expression. Lola reaches out to catch him, but the stranger gets there first. Rami crumples to his knees, cries reverberating around the cave like sirens. Chapter 36, Thursday, Now. For a face he's only seen once before, Johnny figures out who is emerging from the tunnel pretty quickly, and the night watchman has the look of someone who's been up for far longer than just one night. He reaches out reflexively as Rami falls, the familiar weight of dealing with someone in agonized shock, an immediate pressure on his shoulders, pinning him in position. It's an automatic response, he knows that, a learned behaviour, doctors called it. Those many years ago after his mother died, because it was laid down while his childhood brain was still developing, an unexpected path that no child would ever choose unless they were forced to travel it again and again. The freeze setting, rather than fight or flight. Rami's cries, the dog's barks. Johnny's heard those before, too. They land like he's deaf, because he is. Another learned behaviour, to find something else to listen to when the rest of the noise is too loud, so he knows he's humming, too. It just happens. It's his own personal distraction tuning out the storm. He blinks away the child bent over its mother. Suddenly all he can see in a cave full of yellow shadows. What's happened? The girl whispers, tightening her arms around herself.